So my name is Courtney Runnels. I'm the crisis support supervisor for the Grand Prairie Police Department. So I think choosing the right clinician is essential to having any resiliency or wellness program that's going to be successful. I think there's still a lot of stigma surrounding mental health and asking our first responders to reach out and get help. And so if you have the wrong clinician or a clinician that doesn't partner with them well, I think you're going to lose your entire program. So some of the characteristics we look for when hiring a clinician, they have to be relatable. They have to be a good listener. It has to be somebody that an officer can come or first responder can come and talk to, and maybe they want to start off with something that seems a little less threatening. So we look for somebody who can work amongst crisis. We look for somebody who can have compassion, can have empathy, but also can understand how to work through that stigma that getting help doesn't always mean going to counseling. Getting help can be a myriad of things, and helping to arm them with that arsenal of weapons on their tool belt can be really what's most beneficial to that. You have to be there to do that one-on-one peer support. You have to be able to approach somebody who may have experienced a traumatic incident and be able to identify, hey, that call seemed tough. If you need something, I'm here. You have to be present when they're going through something in their personal life, and understanding that as much as we all don't want to bring it to work, the reality is a lot of us do. And so you have to be able to help people identify personal life versus professional life. Some of the other roles might be just providing support and helping them understand that it's okay to be okay, and it's okay to not be okay. Also, the role of your clinician isn't to do counseling. And I think that can be very difficult, because you can't cross that boundary between being a clinician and a coworker. And so you have to have the clinical expertise to recognize what might be going on, but you also have to be able to identify that you're not their counselor. And so helping to lead them to the resources that are going to be most beneficial to them is key. Building rapport as a clinician with staff can be difficult, just because, again, you're dealing with a lot of different types of personalities. And so I think the most important piece for me as a clinician is I'm out there in the middle of it with our first responders. And so I'm lucky enough that I've been a dispatcher, so I can build some rapport with our dispatch staff, and just being able to say, I've been a dispatcher, and maybe I don't walk in your shoes, but I've done that job. And being able to kind of connect with them on a personal level of, you know, hey, this is tough, and let's walk through what you've done. I think another way that you build rapport is just being human and reminding everybody that we may all wear different uniforms and we all may have different titles in front of our name, but at the end of the day, we're all humans and we have to have that human connection. The benefit of having your own internal resource is you control that resource, for lack of a better term, right? A shared resource is beneficial. It's very cost effective. And so some of the benefits of that is you can pull in ideas from other departments, because maybe you're working with other departments and you can see, okay, so this department's doing this, and maybe we can share that resource amongst all three departments. The downfall to that is, again, you're sharing that resource, and so you don't get 100% of that person's time where you would if they were your own internal resource. So if there's a major incident and you're shared resource over, say, three departments, I may not be available, or that clinician may not be available, because their time is being shared with another department, even though you might need them at the same time. We always focus on our physical health, especially in the first responder culture. And while it's great to be physically healthy, being physically healthy doesn't do anything if we're not mentally healthy. And so I think we have to really look at, what are the benefits of having an internal clinician and somebody that we can trust, somebody who understands our culture, somebody that we can have access to, say, 24/7, should there be a crisis? Because the reality is, crisis doesn't stop. And we have a lot of external resources, but we also have a lot of distrust, and our external resources don't always understand our culture. And so I just think that in this day, in this time, with so much focus on mental health and understanding that I can't take care of somebody else if I haven't taken care of myself first, I think we look at, there's really no way to say we can't afford it anymore, because you're gonna pay for it one way or another, be it sick time misuse or workman's comp injuries or use of force. I mean, if we're not taking care of our mental health, it's gonna come out in some way. So our department's paying for it regardless.